Let's quickly go into it, sir. We saw what happened today. We saw what was written in the tabloids today. Leaked audio, from SEC. What do you make of that, leaked audio from SEC?
Yeah, so first thing first, we are saddened to see that the Anti-Corruption Commission was at some point compromised in the course of their duty when they were trying to investigate some minister, in particular Dr. Chitalo Chirufya. What we had known for a long time seems to have been the case that Dr. Chirufya was being targeted by forces that were hidden behind the Anti-Corruption Commission. And that video just confirms that there's something wrong with the Anti-Corruption Commission. Now, what is wrong with the Anti-Corruption Commission? It is that this is an office that is not operating independently. This is an office, a commission that can be manipulated at some point if it is not allowed to have the independence that it deserves. For a long time, some of us have been in the anti-corruption world for quite a long period of time. From 1998, we have been talking about the independence of the Anti-Corruption Commission. A lot of civil society activists have talked about the independence of the commission. Now, we have gone a little bit further to give this commission independence in the constitution, but it has still remained in the hands of the politicians. Even in the last regime, you will discover that the Anti-Corruption Commission was still under the office of the president. Means that those who were so closer or who were able to abuse the president, not the president himself, no, but those who were so close were able to manipulate the entire system to ensure that those who need to be targeted can be targeted by the Anti-Corruption Commission and crippled. And this is the case of Dr. Chitalo Chirufya. We now can confirm that there was a problem at the Anti-Corruption Commission, and this is a matter that should not be glossed over. I think it should be followed up with an investigation as to why innocent citizens should be maligned using commissions such as the Anti-Corruption Commission. All in all, we need to give the Anti-Corruption Commission the independence that it deserves. We need to take it away from the office of the president, because with all good intention,
So
the
for you,
president may wish
you confidently think
to
that,
have
Mr. Mwanza, for you, you
this
confidently think
commission.
you for you, you confidently
Yes.
think that the interference was coming in from the office of the president in the
No, no, no,
previous
no. I'm
regime?
not saying it's from the office of the president, but you see, the office of the president is too big. It is not about the person who occupies that office. There are so many people that surround the president. And if there is somebody who's pulling up the strings to say, can you do this, giving instructions to the Anti-Corruption Commission, most of the time, what the president do, the president of the Republic of Zambia, they do not know what their other people are doing in their office. That is where the challenge is. And it is difficult to point these things to the president himself, any president of the Republic of Zambia, because whatever the president must do, it must be in writing. That is what the Constitution now wants. So the point is that the people that surround these politicians, they begin to abuse the Anti-Corruption Commission. And here, this case looks like it was a fight between those who did not like Dr. Chitalo Chirufya, and he wanted to use the commission to cripple him because the Minister of Health was a quite sensitive place. So we know that there are people that were behind it. And I'm not saying it is the people from the office of the president. All I'm saying is that the commission requires to be very independent. We must take it away from the hands of the politicians. That was the essence of us amending the anti-corruption, the Constitution of Zambia, so that we can give it not only functional independence, but we can also give it the autonomy that it deserves. If the commission was autonomous, we would not see what we would not have been hearing these audios about a director general who is compromised, because no doubt the director general was
compromised. Does this then vindicate that? Does this vindicate number one the UPND, but many other civil society organizations that said that the SCC under Edgar Lungu was not autonomous? It was, you know, being politically interfered with. Does this vindicate those that supported that particular idea that the SCC was not autonomous from your end?
Look, we in civil society, we had said it. Even when Dr. Chirishitari Chirifia was in court, we also had the say over it. We saw the anti-corruption commission officer who went to court to discuss the issue of Dr. Chirishitari Chirifia, and clearly it did not want to lie before the court. And we know how it ended.
Yeah.
Okay. So this has a background that civil society had been suspecting that there is a problem with the commission. And this is not about Dr. Edgar Chagwalungu. The commission has had a problem for quite a longer period of time. It dates back to 1980 when it was formed. It has always been under the directions of some politicians. Even when the independence was given to the Anti-Corruption Commission, the functional independence, there is always this hand that goes in. Even now, as we are talking, we can say now, to say, no, the president has given a good view. Politicians always speak these nice things, to say, no, the commission will be independent, they will do all these, but they will still be under my office. But behind the back, what happens is what we are seeing, what we heard now in that video, that an innocent person was being plotted against by the commission because of other people did not like him. So for us, I think it's a question of how best do we make these commissions independent. I think this is a matter, again, I want to repeat, that at some point we need to take it to court, that the commission must get its full independence and not what we are seeing. That video is damaging to the Anti-Corruption Commission. It is damaging to so many commissions, because it is not just the Anti-Corruption Commission that might be affected. Even the Drug Enforcement Commission and the others, except that these audios have not leaked from these other places. Probably people did not record. So the point is that we need to ensure that these commissions are truly independent and not what we are seeing. That audio is simply telling us to say there was a problem. There is a problem in the Anti-Corruption Commission. Mm. And if we're going to leave it like that, my brother, innocent lives will be messed up because people will be told who to go under arrest.
Of course, lastly, Mr. Mwanza, you speak about someone that could have been innocent. We don't know yet if, well, according to the information we have, because there was no arrest that was effected.
No, but you see, when that, I say that, he's
that
innocent.
That, yes, that means that he's innocent. But my question is this.
Court and he was acquitted.
He was acquitted, of course. And that's the reason I'm saying he's innocent.
Yes.
Can Mr. Chitalo Chirifia, and I want a legal opinion on this one, can Mr. Chitalo Chirifia throw legal, you know, litigation against Rosemary Kuzwayo for this?
It is possible that he can explore all those routes of trying to hold the Director General and others to account, except that, you see, the way the Anti-Corruption Commission Act has been couched is that the officers of the Anti-Corruption Commission, including the Director General, are immune for the acts that they do. They have immunity. Just like the president now, we can talk about the immunity of the president. The Director General enjoys the same immunity. The officers of the Anti-Corruption Commission enjoy the same immunity. And in the Act itself, there is no provision which lifts the immunity of the Director General when they do wrong things.
Mm. Even when they leave office.
This is where the challenge is. But it is a matter that I think is worth exploring, using different angles to ensure that the matter can still be redressed if he feels aggrieved.
Mm. Well, I wish we could go on, Mr. Mwanza, but you know, time is up now. Thank you so much for giving us a legal opinion on you know, what is happening in the country. Thank you so much, Mr. Mwanza, for having joined us.
I'm very grateful.
To watch longer interviews such as this, subscribe to our YouTube channel, Diamond TV Zambia.